Welcome to the voice of the Lord. Our verse for today is in Proverbs 18, verse 24. A man of many companions may come to ruin, but there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. No matter how many friends we have or how many companions we have, we can come to ruin if they don't stick with us until the end. When we need help the most and they won't be there to help us, well, we can get into all kinds of problems because no help is coming. But there is one who will stick closer than a brother. Amen. Just like a blood relative that won't abandon you regardless of what will happen, there will be one of those. So friends, in this particular verse now, we are being reminded to be a good friend to someone. Let's stick closer to our brothers and our sisters. Amen. Remember, friends, that as believers in the Lord Jesus Christ, the foundation of our relationship is the Word of God. And the Word of God should not fail. Amen. Yes, why not? We sometimes have struggled with one another. We have disputes. We have arguments. We cannot agree on certain matters. But it doesn't mean that we abandon one another, right? Otherwise, this will happen. That's why it's a warning, friends, saying that, you know, check your friends. Who are your friends? Are they really your friends, or they are just friends in good times? When there are parties, when there are vacations that have to be enjoyed together, will they just be there for that? How about when there are trying times, when our relationship with one another is fully tested, will they be there? Well, just take comfort in this. At least, we are told that, at least that there will be one that will stick closer than a brother. Amen. Someone will still support you. There should always be one at least. Amen. And so pray for that one and pray for more you can stay strong until the end. Because again, it's good to have a lot of friends in good times. Why not? So many that can come to you in good times when your relationship is not being tried. But as I said, friends, we have our emotions. Sometimes we have our attitude. And what if these emotions and attitudes prevail and it becomes a very contentious issue now? Friends, let us forgive one another. Amen. Forgive and try to understand one another the way that you try to forgive and understand your own brother or your sister. Your brother could be very bad, but he's still your brother. And same with your sister, but they are still part of your family, right? And you try to extend help. Your father, your mother, they might not be the best of the father and the mother, but they still your father and mother. Amen. And you won't abandon them. So same thing in a relationship with a friendship here. Amen. As I said, friends, our relationship is founded on the Word. And Jesus had set a good example when He laid down His own life for us. Amen. And so, why don't we do the same then? Try to understand one another. So, friends, let's stay strong together. Because together we are stronger, but divided we fall. Right? And so why don't we stay together and contend against the real enemy? And the real enemy is the devil. Amen. The spirit of anger and bitterness and resentment and hatred, all kinds of spirits, friends, we have to contend against this spirit together. Resist these spirits that we may prevail and that we may become even closer to God. Hallelujah. And so, friends, again, this is a warning for us. It's good to listen to these words that we may be encouraged to walk by faith and not by sight. Amen. Having faith in one another, regardless of what we see, regardless of what we hear, let's trust one another. Amen. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you and lift up his countenance on you and give you his peace. God bless. See you again next time. Bye.